Translucent shadow color is not supported by Lumen Global Illumination. However, you can enable it using the material option, but the shadow's opacity will match that of an opaque mesh, resulting in an unnatural appearance. In this tutorial, I'll show you a workaround that may not be perfect, but can achieve a more realistic effect by giving you control over the shadow's intensity. We'll begin with a basic glass material using the translucent shading model, with the lighting mode set to surface forward shading, and the refraction method set to index of refraction. The material setup includes base color, specular, roughness, opacity, and refraction based on a Fresnel effect. When applied to a mesh, we notice that no shadow is cast. To fix this, we can enable Cast Dynamic Shadow as Masked and set the Opacity Mask Clip value to a very low value. While this does generate a shadow, the issue remains that the transparent mesh casts a shadow with the same opacity as an opaque mesh, making it look unrealistic. Now, I'll create a material to show you an important concept. You may have heard of Dither Temporal AA. It's a trick that creates the illusion of translucency using an opacity mask with a noise pattern, where the size of the noise determines the illusion of transparency. The downside? It can cause artifacts and ghosting, so it's not ideal for high-quality transparent materials. But the cool part I wanted to highlight is that it reduces shadow opacity, making the shadow look way more natural. So, how can we keep a translucent material while using Dither Temporal AA for the shadow? We can do this with the Shadow Pass switch node by taking the opacity value, multiplying it by a constant parameter, and plugging it into Dither Temporal AA. To keep the noise pattern stable and uniform, set the random value to 0. Now, the translucent material casts a much more realistic shadow. To control the parameters, create a material instance and assign it to the mesh. You can adjust the shadow opacity directly in the material settings. Just make sure to move your model after adjusting this value to ensure it updates correctly. As I mentioned before, this isn't a perfect solution. You might notice some artifacts on your model. From my testing, you can eliminate these issues by lowering either the material's opacity or the shadow's opacity. Another way to fix this is by enabling ray tracing for translucency in the post-process volume. But keep in mind, this will have an impact on performance. As a final touch, for simple models, you can use a spotlight with cast shadow disabled and the specular scale set to 0 to fake a caustic shadow effect. I hope you found this video helpful. If you have any questions or want to share your own optimization tips, feel free to drop a comment below. I'd love to hear your thoughts.